kingdom. What came was the man-made religion of Christianity. That is the religion about Jesus, but not of Jesus. What most are unaware is that Christianity is actually not much more than a copy of the religion of Judaism with Jesus plugged in. This religion, again, was not created by God. God is not a Jew, in the same way that Jesus is not a Christian. These words are nothing but labels comparing itself to other religions. Judaism resulted when the people of God, Israel, committed a threefold sin. They rejected God as their king, they rejected his law, or ignored it and broke it, and number three, they rejected his household rules, his economic principles and statutes, and as a result became a people of whom God himself said, "You rob me in the area of finances," therefore the entire nation is under a curse. After that, historically, followed 400 years of thundering silence. This is the time in between the two testaments, the old and the new. After Malachi, God chose to say nothing anymore for a very long time to his people. And Malachi 3:16 lets us even conclude that he ceased to hear or even listen. He had basically completely switched off. Because people who are just saying, "Lord, Lord," but not do what this Lord says, are not really attracting this Lord's attention. They weary him out. And that is why God has almost completely switched off. The religion of Christianity has come to the very same spot. It has committed the very same threefold sins. It has celebrated Jesus as its Savior, but ignored to obey him as King. It has lost its love for him so much so, where Jesus says, "If you love me, you obey my commands. Teach them to obey everything I have commanded." Most Christians are very unaware of what that even means. And basically, they live outside the law of Christ, the constitution of the kingdom of God. Which government would employ people who refuse to declare an oath of obedience and allegiance to its constitution? It is the same in the kingdom. And finally, almost all Christians are ignoring or breaking God's sacred and holy household rules, kingdom economics. Almost every aspect of Christians and money has been turned upside down in a financial rebellion, twisted by religious traditions and the teachings of self-elected gurus that have left the biblical grounds to follow the principles of the market, of Babylon, but not of Christ. No wonder so many Christians feel saved, but are still lost. They run around in circles, their life is without real purpose, they tread water and they are waiting for something they don't know what. They do their best, including Christian leaders and pastors, to follow the latest and the newest wave, but are dangerously close to a burnout. Their life has become a hamster wheel, predictable religion, rituals, routine. Many are simply running on the fumes of yesterday. And they go through motions of trying to hold the fort. They have become trapped in a religion and are wondering, "How did I even get here? I wanted Jesus, but how did I end up with religion?" Where is God in all this? Let me be very candid with you. He has left the house of rebellion. Ichabod, the glory has departed. God's glory will only come to a place of obedience and of true loyalty, where the threefold sins I have mentioned have been severely dealt with. His glory will come only to places where individuals, families, churches, and entire movements come to true repentance and return to kingdom standards. This is a phenomenal, global, sovereign move of God and a process that I have begun to call ReforNATION, where God is calling his people to come back to his kingship, to his constitution and his household rules. In other words, away from stifling religion and back to the blueprints of the kingdom, his original nation. Where this happens, we can see explosive blessings, apostolic breakthroughs, and literally a reinvention of people, families and entire movements, churches that are being repurposed and rewired to true and healthy kingdom purposes. And let me be frank, not everyone saying kingdom, kingdom truly speaks on behalf of this kingdom. We need to be very alert and discerning with this multitude of voices out there that beckon to follow them. We need to discern that voice of our lover of our soul, our King Jesus, and follow him in exactly the same way as his word declares it. Then heaven will be literally the limit of what God can do to you and through you, because he's intent to bless you and bless others through you. He can, however, only bless what is truly aligned with his kingdom. If you want to get acquainted with the core substance of this new season in the Lord, there is a small free booklet that you can download and read. It is called ReforNATION, and you can download it at this website, www.refornation.eu.